The title of the today's lecture on global culture is M+, the museum that Asia doesn't have. I'm very glad that the director of M+, Lars Nitve, is our today's speaker. Lars Nitve is an art historian, writer, art critic, but first and foremost, he is a museum director for quite a long time. Among other positions, he was the founding director of the Tate Modern in London. Since 4 years, Lars Nitve is the again founding director of the M+ Museum in Hong Kong. He will deliver us now a summary to his speech.
Yeah, so what I'll be talking about is really how we try to create, as we were asked to do, the museum Asia doesn't have. And of course, that means trying to create a museum that has a standing on the same level, in a way, as the Museum of Modern Art in New York, or Centre Pompidou in Paris, or Tate Modern in London, for example, for Asia. But of course, not just copying those museums, but actually trying to create something that is rooted also in an Asian experience, and more specifically, in a Hong Kong experience, because this museum is being created in Hong Kong. I think what we're trying to do is to create a museum that is a museum of visual culture. So it's not just an art museum, it's a museum for design, architecture, moving image, film, etc., as well as art. And we're trying to create a museum that actually looks at the world from a Hong Kong, China, Asia perspective, not looking at the world from the West, but looking at the same periods as these major museums are also have been doing. So in a way, it will be a story about a period we all know, but seen through a different lens. I think a very relevant topic, given that the increasing prominence that Asia has in our sort of global situation. This is a museum also that's being created from inside out. So it's a museum where we don't start with a building, we sort of end with a building. We start with a team that develops ideas and then starts, based on these ideas, start building a collection, the content, the soul and heart and core of the museum. And then when we know where we're going, we sort of start working on also defining and designing the building for the museum. And the building is being designed by the Swiss team, Herzog & de Meuron, and we are now in the process of, well, we've started building, and the building will stand ready in the end of 2018, and then scheduled for opening the museum as a whole in 2019. So another 4.5 years to go, but until then it's an amazing journey, including also a number of exhibitions that we do pop up in Hong Kong, but also in Venice at the Venice Biennial. So if you go there, you can come and see what we're doing. Otherwise, welcome to Hong Kong, definitely in 2019.